Hello everyone, welcome to EduTap and good afternoon to all of you. Please let me know that you can hear me. Everything is fine, you can see me so that we begin with your session today. And I'll just wait, then I'll just tell you a bit about the sessions. First, you let me know that you can see me. So Nilesh is here. Very good afternoon, Nilesh. Vaishali is also here. So am I audible? Kindly write in the chat box. Vaishali, Jagpati, Sameer, great. So you guys can hear me, that's great. Now let me tell you about the session. So I hope you liked the session taken by Yukti ma'am yesterday. We discussed ARD static, some important questions from agronomy or basics of agriculture. Now this series is started for the preparation of phase 2, for the revision of phase 2 actually. And as I've already told you, there was this session by Deepak sir and myself. We took the session and we told you that ARD static was asked a lot in phase 1. So based on that, we would suggest you to go through ARD static part for phase 2 also, because this is the trend in the NABARD examination, that most of the type of questions, the I would say the dimension of the questions asked, dimension of the topics asked is more or less same in phase 1 and phase 2. So for based on that, we started this series, and in this series we'll be discussing some very important topics, starting with ARD static. So yesterday was lecture first. If you've not seen that lecture, I would request you to go back and see that lecture also. The video is available on the channel. So today also we'll be discussing very important questions from agronomy or basics of agriculture, because it is a very important chapter when it comes to your phase 2. Fine. And do remember that I'll tell you, remind me that to tell you most of the important chapters for phase 2. Fine. So before moving, I would like to tell you about the previous results by EduTap. We are blessed with such brilliant results. We are expecting great results even this year. So NABARD Grade A 2019, out of the 41 seats, 25 of our students got selected. Then in NABARD Grade B, 8 seats were there, 4 of our students were there. RBA Grade B 2019 also, we had brilliant results. The interviews are going on and our students, 215 plus students, have already received the calls. 2018 also, you can see we have some brilliant results with us. Now, I hope that you feel confident after these results that you can also do really well, and we'll be really glad if you are able to crack the examination. So here is your very first question. As I said, the questions would be related to agronomy section. So here is the question. Which of the following is not an objective of tillage? So not an objective is asked, okay? The options are to aerate the soil, to break the hard pan, to increase the soil temperature, to make soil loose and porous, or all of the above are actually the objectives of tillage. So tell me the answer quickly. I'll just be waiting for your answer. I can see a query by Arjun, and he's asking how can he start the preparation. Arjun, do remind me about your query at the end of the session, because we have started with the questions. I'll come back to this query after the questions. Today we are going to discuss 10 very important questions. Yesterday you have discussed 15 questions. Today will be 10 questions. I can see option 3. To increase the soil temperature, is it? To increase this, why are you all going with to increase the soil temperature? The answer is, all of the above are actually the objectives of tillage. Objective does not mean that a particular thing has to be done. The temperature of the soil will be increased indirectly also. That can also become an objective of the tillage. If the hard pan is removed, the temperature of the soil is going to increase, right? So the answer is, I can see all of you went with option 3. This is the way you have to apply your knowledge. You cannot see just, I knew this answer, this I have read, and that is going to be the correct answer. I can see the word there. No, no, no. You have to apply your knowledge. That is what the examiner is expecting out of you. So the objectives of tillage are to aerate the soil, to break the hard pan, to increase the soil temperature. The indirect objective it is to make soil loose and porous. So it is again, see, 3 and 4 are related to each other, right? To mix the applied manures and fertilizers with the soil. Fine. So, yes, option 5, not an objective. So, all are the objectives of tillage. Now, types of tillage I have also given here, preparatory cultivation and after cultivation. These are the two types of tillage which are practiced, and preparatory cultivation includes 3 types of further tillage: primary tillage, secondary tillage, and layout of seed bed. So this is just I have given here to provide you an added information that apart from the objectives of tillage, you must know what are the different types of tillage performed. So the various categories of tillage are under the preparatory cultivation. Okay, fine. Moving to next question. Is it clear? Are you guys clear with this question? Can we move to next question? Please let me know so that we can move further. This is fine, right? You will be able to mark the correct answer if it is asked in the examination. Understand that what are the different things can be done. Sameer, the answer was to increase the soil temperature. I would suggest you to brush up the pointers given. Fine. Moving to next question. Thank you, Akansha. Akansha is saying clear. That's great. I'll be moving to next question. I can see hack UPSC. See, I'll not be able to take questions in between here. Please refer to your doubts after the session. Question 2. What is the mineral source of phosphorus? So the mineral source of phosphorus, the options are here: calcite, dolomite, gypsum, apatite and rock phosphate, feldspar, mica, illite, borax and tourmaline, or none of the above. So you have to identify the mineral source of phosphorus. These are the basic questions which are expected from you to be answered. These are all related to your basics of agriculture. Tell me the answer of it, please. I think we should discuss this later on, the questions being asked. You should focus here. Option 3, option 4, option 2. Okay. No unanimous answer here. The correct answer is option 2, apatite and rock phosphate. I know it is not easy to remember all these things, but that is why we are coming up with these sessions, so that you get to know what type of question have we asked. First of all, you remember this answer, you do not mark it wrong. Secondly, the related topics you should brush up. This is the basically the objective of this session. So objectives of tillage was the first question, and the second question I've told you about the objectives of this session. Akansha, you are very much right. Apatite and rock phosphate are the mineral source of phosphorus. So apatite and rock phosphate, you know, so source of boron, potassium and calcium are also given here. Boron sources borax and tourmaline. Potassium is feldspar, mica, illite, and calcium says calcite, dolomite, gypsum. So these you should mark down. This PDF will also be available in the Telegram channel. The link for the same is there in the description of this video, in this lecture. Go there, join a Telegram channel, and then you will get to know about the PDFs. Very right. Someone has told that phosphorus, you can relate it with phosphate. See, boron, borax, you can relate. Then potassium, you have to remember. Feldspar, you can make some acronyms to remember this. Moving to next question. Okay, one value-added information I've given here. That for the apatite reserves in India, West Bengal accounts for the 57% of the total reserves in India, which is followed by Jharkhand and Meghalaya. So you see, most of the reserves are restricted, are in the area of West Bengal, Jharkhand and Meghalaya. What is the mineral resource of iron? This is easy. You must know this answer. So the mineral mineral source of iron is both 1 and 2, that is hematite and pyrite. So hematite, pyrite and pyrolusite 3 were given here, and you had to tell the mineral source. The mineral source is hematite and pyrite. Both are the source of iron. Very right, Sameer. Very much correct you are. So iron has three sources, hematite, pyrite and olivine. And mineral source of manganese is pyrolusite as well as magnetite. So magnetite is related to manganese is related to magnetite, and iron is related to olivine apart from hematite and pyrite. Option 3, correct. This you were able to answer. I can see many of you could answer this question. Identify the macronutrients out of the following. You might see these are the difficult questions, but these are the ones required by you to be remembered in the examination. These are not very difficult. These are related to your basics of agriculture, macronutrients, micronutrients. You must know all these things. So identify the macronutrient. Boron, molybdenum, sulfur, calcium, or both 3 and 4 are the macronutrients. What is the answer? I will tell you about micronutrients also, but you first tell me about the answer. Option 5, is it both 3 and 4? Both. That's great, great. All of you have answered this correctly. Answer is both 3 and 4. That is sulfur as well as calcium are the macronutrients. Now see, macro and micro, two types of nutrients are there. Macronutrients are the major nutrients which are required more. Majority of the percentage required is of macronutrients, while micronutrients are required less for the growth of crops. So macronutrients are actually divided into three subcategories: primary nutrients, secondary nutrients and basic nutrients. So primary nutrients include nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Fine. Secondary, NPK, it's easy, right? Secondary nutrients include calcium, magnesium, sulfur. And basic nutrients, you must know this, it is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So it's very easy to remember it. See, macro and micro, the differentiation is quite easy. Macro means major. The nutrients which are required in majority are macronutrients, and out of these are divided into three categories: primary, secondary, basic. Basic are the ones which are required by all the organisms. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Coming to primary and secondary, primary includes NPK. Fertilizers, usually you read about NPKs only, right? So the leftover calcium, magnesium, sulfur are the secondary nutrients. I think you'll be able to recall it. Will you be able to recall it? It's easy, right? Coming to micronutrients, iron, copper, zinc, boron, molybdenum, manganese and chloride. So molybdenum is considered to be a very kind of nutrient which is asked in most of the time examinations. What is it? So usually students get confused that if it is asked, probably it's a macronutrient. No, molybdenum is a micronutrient. Total nutrient 17, Sunil Meshram is saying. Moving to next question. Growing of one and same crop on the same piece of land year after year is known as dash. Very easy question. I think you can answer it. Prasanth, we are expecting results to be out soon, within a week probably, because in the end of the March, in the last week, we are expecting your phase 2 also. So let's see. You must prepare, start preparation if you are expecting to score decently. Coming to this question, tell me quickly, one and same crop on the same piece of land year after year. Very easy this is. Mono, first answer Sangeeta has given. Correct. Monocropping is the type of cropping in which the same crop is grown year after year. Right? This is easy. See, multiple cropping and mixed cropping are two different types of cropping. So multiple cropping actually includes in one given year, in one cropping season, various crops are grown at a time. Whereas in mixed cropping, there is a minute difference between multiple and mixed cropping. Multiple cropping has the different crops grown on a single piece of land in patches. While mixed cropping includes the different crops are actually not restricted to one particular area. Rather, they are mixed up and grown. Monocropping is year after year. The same crop is grown. Strip cropping is includes wherein a land is divided into strips, and here this strip includes some other crop, this strip includes other crops, this is other crop. So strip cropping is one crop. Then I'll just take the example 1, 2, 3. Then it includes 1, 2, 3 again. So strip is this type of cropping. Fine. What is a decent score? I would suggest if you are scoring above 110, okay, although we are expecting the cutoff to be a bit higher than that, but still, if you are getting more than 110, then you should start preparing. Moving further, component cropping, you please find out and let me know in the comments section. These all croppings are related only. Strip cropping, mixed cropping, multiple cropping. I would suggest you to find out the component cropping and tell me, tell in the comment section below. See here, growing of one and the same crop is monoculture or monocropping. Under rain-fed conditions, paddy, groundnut, cotton, sorghum are grown year after year due to the limitation of rainfall. Which of the following cotton species is the New World cotton? Okay, so two types of cotton species are broadly here, which are known as New World cotton and Old World cotton. So you have to identify the name of the New World cotton. Gossypium arboreum, Gossypium hirsutum, Gossypium barbadurans, option 2 and 3, option 2 and 5. This is again an easy question. Aniket, the timing of the class is 1 p.m. Every day we meet you at 1 p.m. From yesterday only we have started this lecture, and yes, it is going to be a daily class till your phase 2 takes place. All the important topics for phase 2 exclusively would be started here, but if you have not referred to phase 1 lectures which were there, I would suggest you to go back to the playlist on our channel and refer to those videos also. Skip Samir, do not worry, we'll tell you the answer today. Option 4, Vartika, Sangeeta and Akansha are going with option 4. You guys are right, answer is option 2 and 3. So hirsutum and barbadans are actually the New World cotton species. So hirsutum is called as the American cotton and barbadans is called as the Egyptian cotton. So these are the New World cotton species. And arboreum and herbaceum are the desi or old world cotton species. I'll tell you one thing, that hirsutum is actually the predominant species, which is actually your American cotton. In the global production of cotton, 90% of the production comes from this particular species only. And one more fact I would like to tell here, these desi cottons, which we call as old world cottons, these are also called as the Asiatic cottons, because majority of these are grown in the Asian region only. Fine, is this clear? This is important, you must know this. Aniket, you can start preparation. You must actually. Now coming to question number 7. What is the seed rate of cotton plant? Such types of question are earlier also asked in the examination and are expected to be asked further also. So what is the seed rate of the cotton plant? 30 to 40 kilogram per hectare, 20 to 30 kilogram per hectare, 50 to 70 kilogram per hectare, 10 to 12 kilogram per hectare, or 25 to 30 kilogram per hectare. So today we'll be discussing your 10 questions. This is your 7th question here. Is this difficult? I cannot see answer. Samir is the first one to answer this. Aniket says 1. Samir says option 4. Option 2 also I've got. The correct answer is 10 to 12 kilogram per hectare. So option 4 is the answer. Saurav, you are right, and Samir, you were also right. Seed rate of cotton plant is 10 to 12 kilogram per hectare. So under the rain-fed conditions, the desi cotton seed rate, which is grown in India, is 10 to 12 kilogram per hectare. American cotton is 8 to 12, while hybrid cotton seed rate is 2 to 2.5 kilogram per hectare. So we have already seen that American cotton is the most dominant cotton in the global production of cotton, 10 to 12 for desi cotton. What is the water requirement for lentil crops? Sunil is saying desi cotton is 10 to 18 kg. See, 10 to 12 kg, the options you have to go through in the exam, and the correct answer would anyhow you'll be able to mark, because 10 to 12 18 you are saying. We say 10 to 12. So the range is above 10 only, somewhere lying between that. Coming to this question, what are requirement for lentil crops? 150 to 300 mm, option 4. Everyone is able to answer this question. So in phase 1 also the question was International Year of Millets by FAO. What was that year? Are you able to recall? What was the answer to that question? International Year of Millets, as announced by FAO. Do tell me in the comment section. So water requirement of various crops are here. Wheat, rice, maize, groundnut given. So wheat is 250 to 600 mm, rice 1500 to 2500, maize is 500 to 800, groundnut is 500 to 700 mm. 2023, great, that was the correct answer. So here also you got to know the answer. Lentil crop I've already told you. Apart from lentil, four other important crops are also here. Do recall this in the examination. Now coming to next question, identify the incorrect pair of instrument and its use. So you have to tell that which of the instrument given does not have this particular use. Lysimeter is used for evapotranspiration measurement. Pycnometer, specific gravity of soil. Crescograph, measurement of growth of plants. Aneroid barometer is used for atmospheric pressure. Or do you think that none of the above is incorrect? All four options, all four pairs given have this, the use given here only. Tell me the incorrect pair, please, if you can see any incorrect pair. These are the basic questions you are expected to know. And anyhow, you have got to know now. None of the above is incorrect. All four instruments given here are used for the measure of the purpose of measuring the things given here. Correct. Last question. Annual rainfall less than 75% of normal, the situation is known as dash. So rainfall is rainy days are very important for NABARD. It seems in phase 1 also it was asked that according to IMD, the rainy day is defined as what? So the question was that. So taking that on the basis, see, this is also important. Annual rainfall less than 75%. The situation would be drought, severe drought, moderate drought, option 2 and 3 both. That means that it will lie in the range of moderate to severe drought or none of the above. The correct answer is drought here, drought, or also it is called as the normal drought. So annual rainfall of less than 75% of the normal situation. It's normal or drought, normal drought or drought. So if deficiency of rainfall is above 50%, then it is called as the severe drought. Now types of drought I have also given here, kindly find them out, but otherwise the types are here: hydrological, meteorological and agricultural drought. So these are important questions, few important questions we have discussed. That's it. We'll meet tomorrow also. We'll be discussing variety of topics from agriculture static, important agri schemes we'll be also discussing, then important ESI current affairs topics would also be discussed in these lectures. Every day we'll be meeting at 1 p.m. Do tell all your friends who are preparing for phase 2 so that they can benefit from these lectures. Fine, that's it. And yes, one very important announcement. We are running 50% off on the courses of NABARD. NABARD 50 is the coupon code without any space. All in caps. Use this coupon code, avail 50% off. and to boost your preparation. So in case of any query, please drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can even give us a call at 8146207241. I'll be winding up this lecture. And okay, some questions are here. I'll just take a few queries. NABARD result date, I'm getting, okay. See, NABARD, we are expecting the result to be out soon, in a week probably. This week also the result can be out. Satyam is saying, please come up with more number. Satyam, sure, I will try to come up with more number of questions. Today, Yukti ma'am could not come, so I had to take up this lecture. I could prepare these questions only. I'll try to increase the number of lectures and number of questions. One more query I have, what is the safe score? See, as I told you, safe score, if you're scoring above 110, you should start your preparation. Fine. I'm getting around 110, that's fine, Prince, you can start your preparation. We are saying if you're getting 110, you're sure about it, you should start the preparation. Although the cutoff is expected to be, we cannot claim that it is going to be so only, but we are expecting the cutoff somewhere in the category of 115 plus. But to be safe, you should prepare for if you are getting 110 plus. Rajiv, please release Feb current affairs. In the course, Feb current affairs are being updated with videos also. Will be by 10th March, you'll be getting all the current affairs from the month of Feb. AID section, that also will be coming up with the sessions of Feb current affairs from ESI and AID section both. Fine. Sunil, I'll not be able to answer for agri engineering particularly. Important essay topics would also be updated in our course, and we will also be providing the probable essay topics plus the fodder material for the same. The fodder, the topics to be used, topics along with the explanation to be used in writing the essay. Shobhit, the date for phase 2, till now, we are expecting the exam to take place in the last week of March. Fine, I think many queries have taken up today. You're welcome, Rajiv. I would be winding up this lecture now, wishing you all the very best. Prepare really well. We are there with you every day. We will meet. Tell your friends also to join these sessions so that they can take the maximum benefit of these sessions. Fine. Wishing you all the very best. See you tomorrow.